If you're looking to create a new website or refresh your existing website, one of the questions you might have is how should the website be built? Because you probably have heard of platforms like Wix and Weebly and WordPress to make building a website really easy. But which one should you go with? In this video, we're going to talk about some of the pros and cons and differences of those platforms to try to help you figure out which one makes the most sense for you. So first off, what are Wix and Weebly and WordPress? So really simply, these are all different content management systems or CMSs. So what does that mean? Basically, a content management system is a platform typically based on the web where you can really easily create, manage, maintain, and update a website without having to know code. Basically, a loose analogy I use sometimes is if you can create a PowerPoint presentation or update your Facebook profile, you probably have the skills you need at a basic level to learn how to create and manage a website on one of these platforms. It makes it pretty easy. There's always a learning curve whenever you use new software, new platforms, but these are some of the best known and some of the most popular platforms creating a website. So the question is for this video, is one of these a good fit for you? And if so, which one? Well, let's dive in. So to cut to the chase, we're going to dig into some details and nuances that really differentiate these different platforms. But to get to the punchline, here's kind of my bottom line thought, and we're going to talk through why I have this perspective. So generally, I'm going to lump together Wix and Weebly and then separate out WordPress. Generally speaking, Wix and Weebly are really user-friendly basic options. So where those come into play is if you're a small business, a do-it-yourselfer, and need something really basic for your website and you want to do it yourself, those are good options. WordPress is also a really good option, but it's a lot more robust. So longer term, if you're going to grow as a business, if you need more advanced functionality like blogging, e-commerce, WordPress probably is a better fit long term. But let's dig into why that is. So first off, let's talk about complexity and ease of use. So Wix and Weebly both are designed for folks that definitely don't have coding experience. They have really basic interfaces where you can click and drag or select where to put things, and it makes it really easy for a novice to create websites, and their interfaces are designed that way. Part of the trade-off, though, is in order to make the user interface and the experience really simple, the trade-off is they have reduced functionality. So I'm not saying you can't build a decent website in those platforms, they just don't have the same level of robustness as WordPress. So what that means is if you have a business where your website is going to be very basic, like you just need some text, some images, you don't need a lot of advanced functionality. And granted, I know that Wix and Weebly can do more than just a basic website, but if that's all you need, they might be the right fit for you. Whereas WordPress has a lot more functionality, a lot more features. And because of that, there can be a little bit more of a sense of when you first jump into WordPress, it can feel a little bit more overwhelming. There's just more options. There's more things to navigate through. But at a basic level, you can learn WordPress really efficiently as well and also build a lot more robust and a lot more customized websites with that platform. Where this comes into play is really important, especially if you're going to create the website yourself. If you're not a developer but need a website for your business, you're probably going to want something that's easy to manage. So right out of the box, candidly, Wix and Weebly probably do seem to be the easiest options compared to WordPress, especially because of the drag and drop interface that makes it pretty easy to create pages. That said though, one of the ways that WordPress is able to be so much more robust is it offers tons and tons, and I mean tens of thousands of add-ons, which are known as plugins. So plugins are basically other features that you can add onto your website. It's kind of like on your smartphone, how you can go to the App Store or Google Play and download apps also. You basically search for what function or what program you're looking for. You click the install button, it installs, and you're off to the races and can start using that. Pretty similar for WordPress as well. So if you want to have an advanced photo gallery, or an e-commerce component or some sort of social media add-ons, you can go and search for plugins on the WordPress platform, install and set those up for your website also. So one of the plugins or types of plugins you can get for WordPress are what are called page builders. So page builders are basically plugins or add-ons to WordPress that can make the WordPress interface more of a user-friendly or drag-and-drop environment too. So Elementor is a really robust, really well-known and easy-to-use page builder, but there are others such as Divi or Beaver Builder that also make it really easy to use. So if what's really important to you, or one of the things that's really important to you, is ease of use, out of the box, Wix and Weebly might be more intuitive or easy to use. But WordPress also has some different plugins that if you want to add on top a really easy to use drag and drop builder, you can do that also. It just takes a few extra clicks, but there are plenty of tutorials and plenty of ways to learn online how to do that very efficiently. So no matter what, there is a learning curve. Wix and Weebly might be more intuitive out of the box, but WordPress has a lot of options that can simplify things and make it easier for a do-it-yourselfer also. So while we're talking about functionality, let's talk about two really important components, which are blogging and SEO, and those go hand in hand. SEO, or search engine optimization, is critically important to helping your website be found by potential customers when they use Google or other search engines. And a big part of SEO is blogging, being able to produce easily a lot of content on a regular basis using keywords and other relevant information for your target audience. So which platform is better for those things? Now, Wix and Weebly do have ways to optimize your website, but WordPress is way better on this front. WordPress actually started out as a blogging platform, so it's natively and inherently built really well for blogging, which drives SEO. But on top of that, with all the plugins, add-ons, things you do with WordPress, WordPress is by far and away the better option if you really want to optimize your website for search engines. And that part can't be underestimated in importance. So next up, along with how robust the platforms are and how easy they are to use, let's talk about templates or themes. So when you create a website, especially with a content management system, you're gonna need to figure out what should it look like. And granted, if you're not a developer, starting with a blank slate can be pretty overwhelming. But fortunately, all of these platforms offer templates or themes where basically you can choose what you want to have as a general look and feel or aesthetic of your website. And then basically what you do is just drop in your own personalized text, your own images, just to customize that template as a starting point. Now, while Wix and Weebly both have hundreds of different templates, WordPress has thousands and thousands. Now, as a stat to throw out there, there's something like 40% of the world's website use WordPress. It is a very widely used platform, probably the most popular one out there. And that being said, part of that is there's a huge developer community. And these are the folks that develop these extra plugins, but also themes as well. So if you're looking for templates as a starting point, both options, or actually all three options, have a lot of possibility as far as pre-existing themes or templates. WordPress gets the edge, of course, because it has way, way more pre-made themes or templates that you can use as a starting point. So granted, if you're considering a content management system, something else to think about is support. So even if any of these platforms are easy to use, have lots of plugins, have different templates you can start with, there's going to be times where you get stuck, and that's just part of the learning process if you're building a website by yourself especially. So what do these options have as support? So this is a big difference. So Wix and Weebly do have dedicated support teams, whereas WordPress does not. WordPress is a platform that you download and install on your hosting server. So if you want to go with WordPress, granted, because it's so popular, there are lots of tutorials out there, there's lots of videos. If you work with a developer, they can help you out. But WordPress is a little bit different beast in that they don't have a dedicated support team like Wix and Weebly do as well. So one more factor to consider. And then finally, one last thing that's really important to talk about is cost. What is it going to cost if you go with a Wix or Weebly versus a WordPress? Now, granted, these are all relatively affordable. It's not like one's 10 bucks, the other's 1,000 bucks. No matter what route you go for your website, there's going to be fixed costs. And that's kind of how it is. There's just a certain amount you need to allocate every month for hosting in your website. Now, Wix and Weebly are structured pricing-wise a little bit differently than WordPress. So Wix and Weebly, basically you choose a plan, depending on how much storage you want, what features you want, things like that, and you pay a monthly price that's going to cover, in some cases, both your domain. Sometimes that's baked in, sometimes it's extra. So your domain, the hosting platform, and then access to use their content management system. So basically you choose a plan, and then the dollar amount is what you pay every month. WordPress is a little different because it's a content management platform that you install or use on your hosting. And there are some hosts that have integrated WordPress hosting, so really it's not like you need as a user to worry about installing it. It's very, very simple. It's a few clicks, or your developer can do it for you. But basically, WordPress is inherently free to use, but then you need to pay separately for your hosting and domain. So if you go through GoDaddy or WP Engine or SiteGround, you would buy your domain, you would buy your hosting, and then you or your developer would install WordPress on that platform. So pricing is a little bit different. So let's talk actual numbers. So for Weebly, there's a free plan to get started, but if you want to include a domain and also you want to remove ads from your website, it starts at $12 a month, and that goes, depending on what level or what platform you want to go with, that goes up to $26 a month also. So at a basic level for Weebly, we're thinking probably $144 per year, which is our $12 per month plan times 12 months. By comparison, Wix has a basic plan where it's $16 per month that includes the domain for 1 year, and then their plans go up to $45 per month. So with Wix, you're looking at starting around $192 per year, which is $16 a month times 12 months. Now, WordPress is a little bit different beast. As mentioned, WordPress in of itself is free to use. So if you went with an option like SiteGround for hosting, their basic plan is $2.99 per month. And then you can buy a domain from them for $17.99 per year. So going this route, you'd be looking at about $53, $54 a month, which is $3 a month for hosting, and then $18 a year for the domain as well. So not free, but really affordable as far as domain and hosting goes. But then if you wanted to go with a more robust hosting platform, let's say WP Engine, which is one we recommend a lot, you're looking at $20 a month plus a domain. So with WP Engine, let's say $240 per year, which is hosting. Then you separately need to buy your domain. Let's say you go with Google Domains for $7 a month. You're looking at $247 a year. So bottom line, when it comes to the pricing, they're all kind of a similar ballpark. If you're going with Wix or Weebly, you're probably in the 150 or so range going that route per year. If you go with WordPress, the price is going to depend on your hosting. So it could be as low as $50, $60 per year. It could be $200 or more depending on who your hosting provider goes with as well. So really bottom line, I'd encourage you to really think about, unless budget is super, super tight, to think about what platform makes the most sense over just being purely price driven. So all this being said, there's some different considerations as far as what platforms have for features, how hard they are to use, cost, things like that. Bottom line, let's summarize though what makes the most sense. So Wix and Weebly, while we've grouped them together, are very similar as far as what they offer. If you think either of those could be an option for you, really it's going to depend on what your actual website needs are to do a side-by-side for you to look at both of those on your computer and say, okay, what features do you need, what bells and whistles, and really which of those two make the most sense, because WordPress is just inherently a little different. So bottom line, which should you go with, a Wix or a Weebly or WordPress? So my advice and my reference points are, if you're just getting started out as a business, if you just need a basic website, or your website is one of those things where you're like, no one's really going to visit it, but I kind of need it to check the box, Wix and Weebly might be a good option for you. And also, if you are going to be the person that's going to create your website and maintain it, they might be a little bit easier for you to use if you're not someone who thinks of themselves as being really tech savvy. If you don't want to have to learn a new platform, those might be the better option for you. But if you are an existing business, if you are at a point where you feel like you need to build a website for the long term, if you feel more comfortable with learning software and new platforms in general, WordPress is probably going to be the more robust, better long-term option for you. And especially if you're going to outsource design and development anyways, I'd probably let the developer work on WordPress for you. It's going to be a better long-term fit, probably more robust, better SEO options. There's a lot more developers that will support it. Probably a better platform, and that's why it's used by so many different companies and businesses across the globe as well. So generally speaking, if you know all else being equal, I would say generally WordPress is kind of the jack of all trades. It does a really good job on all different kinds of websites. But if you want something really simple, if you're a do-it-yourselfer, if you're just getting started out and just need a basic website, Wix and Weebly could be good options for you as well. So there you have it, a really concise rundown on some differences and considerations for comparing Wix or Weebly or WordPress and thinking about which one might make the most sense for your business and your website. And granted, there are lots of other content management systems out there as well. These three are just some of the most popular ones and ones you're going to hear the most about and ones we see people working with the most, especially Wix and Weebly when they're just getting started out with a new business idea as well. But of course, if you have any questions, comments, feedback, or would like to discuss these, we'd love your thoughts in the comments section, or feel free to get in touch with us as well. If you'd like to learn more about our team at Buddy, you can visit our website at buddywdd.com. And if you'd like to get in touch about a possible project, you can certainly let us know by clicking the button in the upper right-hand corner, answering a few basic questions, and we'll follow up right away to get a conversation with you scheduled. So that being said, as always, thanks so much for watching. Hope this has been helpful for you, and we'll talk to you again real soon. Wow.